Good morning students. Today we can start exercise 5.3. In exercise 5.3, two type functions. First one is implicit functions. What is implicit functions means? Already we have studied y equal to sin x. Differentiate y equal to sin x, this like one function. Already you have studied, isn't it? Then implicit function means 2x plus y equal to sin x. This form. In here we can differentiate directly. Otherwise, this 2x bring to right side. Then you can make same like previous question. Then this type function is known as implicit function. In exercise 5.3, question number 1 to 8, we will do implicit function. We will use all the normal formulas only. Then remaining question. Remaining question is derivative of inverse trigonometric functions. Two type functions. First one is implicit, second one is inverse trigonometric function. Then for inverse trigonometric function, we will use some formula we have not studied till now. First we can do question number 1 to 8, that is implicit functions. Then after we can see formulas of inverse trigonometric functions. Our question is find dy by dx. Question number 1 is x plus 3y equal to sin x. This is question number 1. Before I told, we can make y equal to one function. Otherwise, directly you can differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. How can I write? D by dx of 2x plus d by dx of this 3y, then d by dx of sin x. D by dx of 2x, 2 is constant, can keep outside, isn't it? Then d by dx of x, it will be 1, isn't it? Plus 3 is constant, then dy by dx equal to d by dx of sin, what will be? It will be cos x. D by dx of sin x is cos x. And then d by dx of 3dy by dx equal to cos x, this 2 into 1, 2, this 2 bring to right side, that will be minus 2 dy by dx equal to cos x minus 2. This 3 bring to right side, that will be divided by 3. Now we got answer dy by dx equal to cos x minus 2 divided by 3. Then question number 2. 2 is 2x plus 3y equal to sin y. This is also an implicit function, isn't it? We can differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. What will get in here? You can write dy by dx of 2x plus dy by dx of 3y dy by dx sin y. D by dx of 2x, 2 is constant, write same 2. D by dx of x, 1, isn't it? I need to write. Plus, this 3 write first. Dy by dx equal to d by dx of sine. Sine will be cos. Cos y. Again, you have to take differentiation of this y. You can write dy by dx. Okay, in here, how many dy by dx? 2 are there, isn't it? we can bring all in one side. Okay, 2, just keep in here, cos y dy by dx, this 3 dy by dx bring to right side, 2 equal to dy by dx take outside, then remaining cos y minus 3, isn't it? Then 2, this cos y minus 3 bring to right side, that will be left side, that will be cos y minus 3 dy by dx. Our answer is dy by dx equal to 2 by cos y minus 3. Very easy, nothing is there. Just use all the derivatives in here, then you can find out very easily. Now we can see question number 3. Just pause the video and write it down in your notebook. Question number 3, ax plus by square equal to cos y. You can differentiate both sides with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. A dy by dx of ax plus d by dx of by square d by dx of cos y. That's derivative all the times. Then d by dx of a is constant, right? First d by dx of x, that will be 1, no need to write, isn't it? Plus in here what is constant? B. Then dy by dx of y square will be 2y. First you will do square, isn't it? Then already you have studied that formula, d by dx of x raised to n, n x raised to n minus 1. In here n, that's why we have written n x raised to n minus 1. The number 2, isn't it? That's why we can write 2, variable is y. Y, 2 minus 1, 1. Then again you have to differentiate this dy by dx equal to d by dx of cos y. Cos means minus sine y. Then again dy by dx. A equal to this dy by dx, and here also one more, isn't it? Write in one side, minus sine y dy by dx, this minus 2by dy by dx. A equal to, and right side dy by dx common, isn't it? Take outside, then remaining minus sine y minus in here 2by. Inside the bracket, what are things? Just bring to a left side. What you will get? A already is there. Divide by minus sine y minus 2by equal to right side. Remaining dy by dx. This minus we can write upside, minus a divided by remaining sine y, in here remaining plus 2by dy by dx. First this minus, 2 minus are there, take outside, then only write upside. Okay, don't write only this minus. Now we got answer. Just pause the video and write in your notebook this answer. Now question number 4 is xy plus y square equal to tan x plus y. We have to differentiate. Then differentiate with respect to x. You can write dy by dx, dy by dx, d by dx of first function xy plus d by dx of next y square equal to d by dx of tan x d by dx of y. Let's take differentiate. Then, in here, d by dx of xy. In here, we have to use product rule. Already we have studied product rule, isn't it? What is product rule? D by dx of uv equal to u dv by dx plus v du by dx. It's like on product rule we have studied, isn't it? That product rule we can apply in here. First, u dv by d. In here, u means x, v means y. Plus v du by dx. In here, v is y. Applying here product rule. Plus d by dx of y square. Y square we can write 2y, because derivative of y square. Square we will do first. 2y. Then again dy by dx equal to d by dx of tan. Tan means what? Sec square x plus dy by dx. Then we can rearrange here x dy by dx. What will get in here? Here only one dx by dx. One, isn't it? Okay. Then remaining 2y dy by dx. This dy by dx also bring to left side. That will be minus dy by dx equal to remaining sec square x. Look, in here what is remaining? A dx. Dx by dx 1 we got, then remaining y all, isn't it? That y bring to right side, that will be minus y. Take a dy by dx outside. Then, what are things remaining? In here x, in here 2y, in here minus 1. X 2y minus 1 equal to 6 square x minus y. Dy by dx sec square x minus y, all divided by this terms going to right side, divided by x plus 2y minus 1. Now we got answer dy by dx equal to sec square minus y divided by x plus 2y minus 1. Okay, write in your notebook, pause the video. This is question number 5. Here also same. We have to find out derivative. Let's take differentiate with respect to x. Then we can write d by dx of first term is x square, then d by dx of xy plus d by dx of y square d by dx of 100. First, d by dx of x square will be 2x. D by dx of xy, what will do then? We'll do product rule, isn't it? Use product rule then. D by dx of uv, u dv by dx plus v du by dx. This is known as product rule. Use that rule in here. First, u means in here x. Dy by dx plus v du by dx. V means in here y, dx by dx. Then dy by dx y square. Y square means you can write 2y. 2y. Then again dy by dx. D by dx of any constant, that will be 0. Then 2x plus x dy by dx plus y dx divided by dx. Dx by dx, 1, isn't it? No need to write. Then remaining 2y dy by dx. From here, we can take a dy by dx outside. Isn't it? Then remaining x plus in here remaining 2y equal to this 2x and plus y bring to right side, that will be 2x become minus 2x, plus y become minus y. Dy by dx equal to minus 2x minus y divided by x plus 2y. This is our answer, question number 5. Write down in your notebook. Now question number 6, x cube plus x square y plus xy square plus y cube equal to 81. In here also we can take derivatives both sides. In second term we have to use product rule. In here, in third term also we have to use product rule. Then you will get answer directly. We can see, differentiate with respect to x. D by dy x cube and plus dy by d. D by dx of first x cube, then d by dx of second term is x square y, d by dx of third term is xy square, d by dx of y cube, d by dx of 81. Then d by dx of x cube, already we have studied formula. D by dx of x raised to n, d by dx of x raised to n is n x raised to n minus 1. Use that formula in here, n means 3, isn't it? 3 x raised to n minus 1, 3 minus 1 is 2. In here, use product rule. What is product rule? D by dx of u, v equal to u dv by dx plus v du by dx. That is product rule. Applying here in second time. First, u means x square. Then dy by dx plus v du by dx. What is v? Second term, y. Then d by dx of u means x square. In here also same product rule used. X d by dx of v means y square plus next v. What is v? V means y square. Second time, y square dx by dx plus d by dx of y cube. That one we can write 3y square. D by dx of x raised to n. Same formula is it? 3y square. In here variable is y. That's why what we'll do? We'll take dy by dx equal to d by dx of 81. 81 means one constant. When you differentiate constant, you'll get answer 0. 3x square plus x square dy by dx plus y d by dx of x square, that will be 2x plus this x again dy by dx of y square. Y square means 2y, then again you have to do d by dx, dy by dx plus y square dx by dx, that will be 1. No need to write. Then 3y square dy by dx equal to 0. Rearrange. In here, in second term, dy by dx is there. In here also dy by dx. In here also dy by dx. That dy by dx take outside. Then remaining x square plus here remaining 2xy and last term 3y square equal to 3x square, 2xy and y square. without dy by dx. All the time bring to right side. What will get? Will get minus dx square. Then this one also. This plus change to minus. Minus 2xy. Then this plus y square become minus y square. Dy by dx equal to minus 3x square 2xy. All divided by this term. Bring to right side. Divide by x square plus 2xy plus 3y square. That is our answer. Write down in your notebook. Question number 7. Question number 7 is sine square y plus cos xy equal to kappa. Okay. In here also, we have to find out dy by dx. Just differentiate both sides. Differentiate with respect to x. Again, right. D by dx of first sine square y plus d by dx of cos xy. Okay. D by dx of kappa. D by dx of sine square. Square change it first. I will write 2 sine y. Isn't it? Then d by dx of sine y. Now we did only square. Isn't it? This formula. D by dx of x raised to n. Using this formula we can change the square. Then remaining sine y is there. Take it. Then d by dx of cos. Cos means what? Minus sine, isn't it? Minus sine xy. Then again you have to do d by dx of x into y. We did only cos. We change like sine, isn't it? Then remaining x into y is there. Equal to d by dx of constant. That will be 0. 2 sine y. Write as it is. D by dx of sine. What is it? D by dx of sine. Cos y. Again, d by dx. Then minus sine xy into. In here, what we will do? We will use product rule, isn't it? Already you have studied, you know that one. Dy by dx plus second term, that is y, then dx by dx. Then, what is 2 sine y cos y? 2 sine y cos y. In class 11, already you have studied one formula, this right. 2 sin x cos x equal to sin 2x. So, it's like one formula I was studied in class 11. Same formula we can apply in here. 2 sin y cos y is sin 2y. Then, dy by dx minus this sin xy given side sin xy into x dy by dx. Then again minus sin xy into here remaining y. Because dx by dx, what is that? It is 1, isn't it? No need to write. Equal to 0. Look, this x, just write up first. This y also write in here. That is better. Then, what is next step? Dy by dx take outside. And from here. And from here. Dy by dx take outside. Then remaining sin 2y. Minus, in here remaining, x sin xy. Equal to. In third term, no dy by dx, isn't it? That term bring to right side. This minus change to plus. Y sin xy. dy by dx equal to, inside the bracket, this part bring to right side, that will be divided by y sine x y, all divided by this term, sine 2y minus x sine x y. This term bring to right side, we will get answer. That is question number 7 answer. Only one thing, keep in mind this formula, 2 sine x cos x equal to sine 2x. We can see question number 8. Sin square x plus cos square y equal to 1. Differentiate both sides. Can write differentiate with respect to x. Dy by dx of sin square x plus here d by dx of cos square y equal to d by dx of 1. Now we can differentiate d by dx of sin square x. Let's do it square. Square will be 2 sin x d by dx of sin, we have to do sin x, plus d by dx of cos square. Square will be cos y, then dy by dx of then cos equal to d by dx of 1. Constant means 0. Then 2 sin x d by dx of sin, it will be cos, isn't it? 2 cos y dy by dx of cos y, that will be minus sin y. Okay, we can write 2 sin x and here cos x plus 2 cos y in here minus sin y, isn't it? Again you have to do d by dx of y, or dy by dx equal to 0. This minus just write first. 2 cos y sin y dy by dx equal to this, bring to right side. This term bring to right side. Dy by dx equal to minus 2 sin x cos x divided by minus 2, this part minus 2 cos y sin y. By dx of minus minus, cut it. Then what is this? 2 sin x cos x. Previous question we did. What is that? That is sin 2x. Divide by, and here also 2 sin y cos y. That also sin 2y. This is our answer. Then up to question number 8, that is implicit form. Then question number 9 onwards, we will do inverse trigonometric function. We can do in next class.